afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Performing Arts School and the Salon Series. My name is Deb Joyle. I am the director here at the school. I am so pleased to welcome our guests, Wes and Julie Krygsman. It will be a very festive afternoon of brass tunes and holiday favorites. And welcome and enjoy.
As she said, we are Wes and Julie Krygsman. That one is Wes. I am Julie. We are obviously tuba and trombone players. We want you guys to have fun today. Please don't feel like you have to sit quietly and behave yourself. You are at a low brass recital. Please misbehave.
Yeah, we can't behave ourselves either.
Yes. If you like what you hear, feel free to clap along or sing or dance, mingle, talk, be merry. If you don't like what you hear, I am told there's lots of wine over there. So please indulge the better, we sound better when you drink more. So we're gonna get started with the first three pieces that we're playing. We're just gonna go straight through. We'll be starting with more traditional holiday pieces, Deck the Halls, O Come All Ye Faithful, and Hark, Herald Angels Sing.
Yeah.
way too much.
Yeah.
Talk amongst yourselves. We're low brass players. We're used to bad behavior.
Yes, we sit the furthest from the conductors. So when we sit really far from the conductors, we get away with a lot more.
Yes.
I know the conductors know that. So if Helen is watching, I know Helen probably knows this. But the low brass is the fun row because we're so far. Hey, I was just speaking of Helen. Welcome. It's as if a Christmas miracle has occurred. We say her name and she appears.
So as
welcome
we were
home
saying, low brass is the most behaved section of anyone.
Yes. And we never fool around in the back row because the conductor will totally hear everything that we say. All right. Here's Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Generally sit in the back row of an orchestra or of a band, and we don't generally get the melody too often. Trombone is more likely to get a melody than a tuba, so it's really nice. We figured for this recital, when we were really thinking about what we wanted to do, is just play all melodies as much as we can. So that is our plan. We're literally just playing as many melodies as we can to get it all in now, because we didn't get to play that many this whole year. So we're doing our best to just make everybody feel relaxed, because we know this time of year is stressful for a lot of people for a lot of reasons, and we don't want that to happen at all while you're here or while you're watching via streaming. So our next song, I will take this off for, you're never gonna guess what our next song is. I'm not gonna tell you, I'm not gonna give you any hints.
It's quite serious.
It's very serious, and I take it very seriously. So, we are going to be playing, I forgot I have to put this one on first.
Don't you have ears?
So let's see if you can figure out what it is, just by this.
Frosty.
Yes, exactly. All right.
Where are your antlers?
I'm not as festive.
Yes. She has the better sweater, so I get more of the... All right, so here is, of course, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Thank you.
actually going to take a moment to pause there because I do want to explain the rest of the piece. There's a really popular holiday movie by National Lampoon's called Christmas Vacation, and in it, Cousin Eddie is outside emptying his chemical toilet from the RV into the sewer, and during this, one of the world's best tuba players, who's named Tommy Johnson, he was instructed to play as inebriated as he can possibly sound on the tuba. So here's one of the world's best tuba players, and they wanted him to actually sound bad on purpose for this scene. And he did, and if you can picture this melody, I'm gonna try to recreate it as best as I can. So here's the rest of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer in the style of National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, Cousin Eddie scene. Although we're not wearing that color today.
All right, so the next piece is the most famous version of it was done by Elvis. Although I do encourage you, the funniest version I've ever heard when I was a little girl, it was recorded at some radio station. It was somebody doing Blue Christmas as Porky Pig. So if you can find this, please listen to it, it's fantastic. So this is Blue Christmas. Imagine that I have Wes's sideburns and cooler hair, and that you're thinking Elvis.
Moment, I just want to call out myself on a funny little mistakes I was making during this, because I'm a classically trained, classical mostly tuba player, and every once in a while we get called on to play improvised bass lines, sometimes over a chord chart. So I wrote out the chords, and I still, you know, I should have written out the whole bass line. So my classical nature got the better of me just then. So I apologize to any jazz bassists watching. Our next piece, we're going to play three more kind of more traditional tunes. I'd like to mention the book that we're reading out of was kind of an accident. When we heard about the Salon series, we actually had a very serious recital set up already for this year. We've been playing in a few different towns so far, and we wanted to do something fun. So it's actually difficult to find just the melody in bass clef for either trombone or in the tuba range. So I scoured the planet and tried to find all this stuff, but then there was something just sitting in my library, and it was this book of duets that you heard the first three tunes and now these three tunes. And it just happened to be from an older trombone player who had long retired and unfortunately passed away. His family was getting rid of a bunch of music, and they asked if I would, you know, want to take care of this. And it is a lot of work when that something like that happens. Most people say no, but there are these weird gems in these, you know, old treasure troves of libraries. And it was totally worth it, basically just for this book. I have no idea who these arrangements are by. I have no idea if this is out of print or in print, but we've been liking them a lot to be able to play duets, actual duets together. So here's our next three pieces. The first one, it's interesting because the word Noel can mean Christmas carol. It can mean Christmas itself, but we only play the first one. So if it is a Christmas carol, we play the first Noel. But what about the second and the third and the fourth and the fifth and all the other Noels? The only one that matters is the first one, I guess. So we'll play the first Noel, then we're gonna go O Little Town of Bethlehem, and then We Three Kings.
Got a wreath on my shirt, sorry.
Yes, wreaths get in the way on trombone. Yeah. Condensation, not spit. Condensation. Okay, it might be a little bit spit. Yeah. That was mostly condensation. Don't you worry. Yeah, the front row is called the splash zone. Nobody gave you the plastic bags put over.
Thank you.
up to We Three Kings. I was gonna make a joke about something about the gifts that were given, but then I was like, wait, that's the three wise men, the kings might have been separate, and then I get that story confused sometimes, so I decided to not make the joke, but tell you about the joke that I was going to make. So just make it as awkward and uncomfortable as possible and make her roll her eyes. That was my goal.
Already happened.
It already happened like three or four times. All right, We Three Kings. Players possibly playing an entire hour's worth of music with barely talking and playing mostly melody is that we do physically get tired, even low brass, high brass players, I know it happens, but even low brass. So we're going to give Julie a little break, and I'm going to play some solos. Is my stuff in there that I need? Okay. So I'm going to play a few tuba solos for you, just the melodies. So the first one I'm going to play, we heard already about Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. I am going to take this hat off, and I'm going to add another silly prop, and I am going to play Frosty the Snowman. I'm going to put it up here so I can still see. So this is Frosty the Snowman as a tuba solo. I apologize in advance. Just the melody for some of these things, and it was funny, I forgot about this book that I actually bought during the pandemic, and at the time we all had to be by ourselves, and for good reason, to try to stay separate, to not spread that horrible disease that was going around, and I bought this book called Christmas Carols for the Lonely Tubist. That's the real title. It's written by a horn player named Sean Brown was another color wearing a green sweater. That's why I went there. Sorry, Sean, if you're watching. But Sean Brown wrote these out, and what it is, it's actually the melody of some Christmas carols, but with a fun twist at the end. He writes them as theme and variations. There's usually only one or two variations, but what that means, at the turn of the century, the last century, I should say, in 1900s, early 1900s, the most famous and popular musicians of the time were the soloists in the John Philip Sousa Band. And what they would do is they would take a melody of the day. So like if you could picture maybe the song Happy by Pharrell, and you could picture, you know, everybody knows that tune and everybody kind of remembers it. So it's a song that everybody knows. They would take that, play it as a solo, and then embellish it and embellish it and embellish it so that it just kept getting more and more crazy, showing off their virtuosity. So that's kind of what I'm going to do here. So the first one that I'm going to play for you is Good King Wenceslas. Now, another funny thing about Good King Wenceslas is I do teach 4th and 5th grade band and strings, and this song is actually one of the tunes that we do play for our winter concert. So this past week, I did this song 4 times with 4 different elementary bands and 3 different elementary bands, 1 strings group, and Good King Wenceslas. We just pick it because it has a lot of, it has a limited number of notes, except this one at the end does have that variation. So I hope you enjoy this Good King Wenceslas on Lonely Tuba. For the Lonely Tubist. I'm just gonna keep adding props to my head, apparently. Funny to note that there also is an option to play this down an octave, so of course I'm exercising that option because it says it on the part. So all of you composers and conductors that tell us not to, it says to. I'm only following directions. Thank you. to take these off, and Julie will come back out, and...
Now, I know what you're thinking. This is not traditional Santa footwear, but if you know anything about me, you know I love a good shoe.
Oh.
So, I thought Santa's traditional look had to be updated a little bit. So, we go back into a slightly higher voice than how Wes just finished that off. I'm going to be playing Silver Bells for you next, which is a piece of music that has been ingrained into my head since I was a little girl. This is my grandmother's favorite Christmas song. She sang it very poorly. And whenever I hear this, I just hear her in the kitchen helping make meatballs and whatnot, singing this. So, Silver Bells in the back of my head. Hopefully I'll sound a little bit better than that. So this is for my Mima. Christmas things that I grew up on, I'm sure everybody else has, is chestnuts roasting on an open fire, which is really called the Christmas song, which is quite confusing because it's chestnuts roasting on an open fire. Here we are. warmer playing in a Santa suit. So, Santa suit, Santa. This song left me conflicted as a child and having many questions as an adult. You know, Michael Jackson did it, and it's a popular thing, but a very conflicting message of, I saw mommy kissing Santa Claus.
Shoot, I have the boots. I like those better. Those are nicer. Okay. Well, now we'll both be warm.
All right. You good?
Yes.
All right. The next piece we're going to play is one of my all-time favorites because it was made famous by one of my all-time favorites, Judy Garland in Meet Me in St. Louis. And an interesting fact about this piece, it originally had some very dismal lyrics. If you look them up, it was more about, we're not going to be here for very long, we might as well enjoy ourselves now, because pretty soon we'll all be gone. Luckily, the lyricist changed things, so it had a much more uplifting message, which I always think of this piece, whether you celebrate the holiday season for Christmas or whatnot, it always gives you a hopeful feeling of, let's celebrate now, and next year will be even more glorious and wonderful and happy. As a hypocrite, I'm going to play this because although I do love the holiday season, I love it from an indoor standpoint. I am not a winter child. I am a summer child, and so I just, Mother Universe, please do not take this as a request. Traditional Christmas piece, very beautiful. We always love hearing this, whether it's brass or strings or any type of ensemble. The piece is called Silent Night. We would like to dedicate this to our next door neighbors who, living next to two brass players, never get one.
At least they get it now, right now.
Right now.
At this moment.
They even punished themselves by coming to one of our recitals this year. In all seriousness, we have the best neighbors in the whole world. During the pandemic, when everything was shut down, we had a brass sextet that met distance in our backyard. And we said to ourselves, the second that anybody complains, we'll pack it up, and that's the end of that. Our neighbors actually came outside on their patios with their dinner and enjoyed, and it was really, really lovely. So it goes to show you, when the world shut down, people still need music and art and things to enjoy, and that was one of the ways that they still got to. Maybe living next door to musicians isn't so bad.
Yes, enjoy the North Pole. this was billed as a holiday celebration. And it's hard to fit in all the holidays. People celebrate a lot of different things and don't celebrate a lot of different things. So I thought it would be a good idea if I could just try to jump in and do at least one other holiday besides Christmas. And of course, it just finished, so I'm sorry that I'm a few days late, but this is the Hanukkah song as a tuba solo. The theme and variations, that's what I meant to say. This one is a very popular holiday tune, and it is called Jingle Bells. But you remember, the theme and variations happen in this one. So many musicians will know that Jingle Bells is usually in 2-4 or 4-4, but in the middle of this one, it changes to a fun waltz in 3. So I hope you like this weird version of Jingle Bells for solo tuba. Because, you know, it's tuba alone and it's kind of silly. It, no matter what, even if when I play something serious, it does end up being a little bit sillier on the tuba, which I'm fine with. I embrace that fully. This most serious music still played on tuba can, I think, sometimes be taken that way. But now we're going to add trombone. We're going to play a duet version of Jingle Bells for you, just because we couldn't decide between these two, so we're doing both. So here's Jingle Bells again. Thank you. For you. The first one is Joy to the World. And the second one, we need you to sing along with us. And it is Auld Lang Syne for the new year and leaving all those worries behind from the previous year to start fresh. So thank you everybody so much for having us. We've had tons of fun playing for you and I hope you have enjoyed it as well. I hope it's brightened your holiday season. Is there anything you'd like to add that I forgot?
Thanks for coming, and you behaved entirely too politely.
They're all definitely on the nice list, but the low brass is usually on the naughty list, so. All right, Joy. I can tell you that I forgot the lyrics to just about every single thing that I play regularly. I just, for some reason, cannot remember the lyrics. So if you do know the lyrics to Auld Lang Syne, please, please, please sing along, because I need to learn the words again, and you'll help me do that. So thank you.
The lyrics are not bold.
That is a great impression of a tuba sound.
Thank you.
I resemble that remark. All right, we're going to do our best to make this as beautiful as we can.
Thank you.
happy holidays, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right. As much. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much to both of you. Happy holidays, everyone, and thank you so much for coming.
Thank you. As much as we'd love to chat and mingle, we do actually have to be somewhere in about an hour, and it is about an hour away.
Oh,
so we're going to do our best to get there.